In this video, I will show you how to copy a sketch from one face to another face of a 3D model. Let's create a sample model. Select Part Design Workbench and create new file and select Create Sketch, select XY plane. And let's draw the hexagon, but first make sure you have auto constraints turned on. Okay, now select hexagon and place the center of the hexagon at the origin point and the second point place on the x-axis. Okay, right click to cancel this command. Select constrain diameter. Select this circle and enter 200 millimeters as the diameter of this circle. Okay. And click close to exit the sketch. Select path feature and enter 50 millimeters as the length of the extrusion. Okay. Now select this face and select create sketch. Create some geometry, for example, circle and rectangle. Okay, and let's add dimensions. Okay, adding dimensions is important because one way to copy a sketch will link the copy of the sketch to the source sketch. Okay, click close to exit the sketch. And now suppose the goal is to copy this sketch onto this face. And the first way is simply copy and paste. Select the sketch you want to copy and press Ctrl plus C. Okay. In object selection window, select only the sketch you want to copy and make sure this box is unchecked. Auto select depending objects. It should be unchecked. And click OK. And then press Ctrl plus V. And here we have a new sketch and notice that the sketch is outside of body. And in order to use this sketch to perform operations on this solid, the sketch must be inside this body. And to do that, just drag this sketch to body. Okay, the sketch is inside the body and now we need to place this sketch on this face. Select this sketch and for property map mode, select these dots. First, click on this box and this button will appear and click on this button and then click this button and pick the face you want to copy the sketch to. Click OK to confirm. And this is one way to copy a sketch from one face to another. Okay, let's refresh the view. And let's turn off the visibility of this sketch for a moment. Select this sketch and press the space bar. And now I will show you the second way to copy sketch. Select this face and create a new sketch. Now, to copy the source sketch, select Create Carbon Copy and click on the sketch you want to copy. But at this point, this sketch cannot be copied, but when you hover over this sketch, a message will appear in the lower left corner to press Ctrl plus Alt to allow a copy of a sketch that is not parallel to this sketch. Press Ctrl plus Alt and then left click on the sketch you want to copy. And the sketch with the dimensions was copied to this new sketch. Click Close to exit sketch and make this sketch visible. And we have three sketches here. One source and two copies that were created in different ways. Now I will edit the source sketch and change some dimensions. Okay, close the sketch and pay attention to the rest of the sketches. The one that was created with copy and paste has not changed, and the one that was created with carbon copy has changed and looks the same as the source sketch. Now if you go to edit the second sketch that was created with copy and paste, you can change the dimensions of this sketch. For example, change diameter of this circle. Okay. And if you go to edit the third sketch that was created with carbon copy, you cannot edit dimensions of that sketch because they are linked to the source sketch and are dependent on the dimensions of the source sketch. Okay, close sketch. And those were two ways to copy a sketch from one face to another. And in the same way, you can copy sketches from one plane to another. Of course, you can use these sketches for 3D solid operations. For example, path, okay. Pocket here, okay. And another path operation, okay. In this way, you can use one sketch to create several different 3D solid features from a 2D sketch. And even if you use this sketch to perform some operation, you can also copy it. In some cases, these methods will save you some time. That's all for today. Thanks for watching and please subscribe to this channel. This will support the growth of this channel and the creation of more lessons.